Before we get underway with tonight's contest, we'll introduce both teams, beginning with the starting 11 for the visiting Gonzaga Bulldogs. In goal, wearing number 1, Chris Lorimore. Number 3, Grayson Lee. Number 6, David Sigurdsson. Number 7, Ben White. Number 8, Christo Michelson. Number 9, Connor Bevan. Number 10, Jacob Branlin. Number 11, Dennis Calamar. Number 15, Jalen Schiffler. Number 16, Nick Mulewicz. And number 19, Colton Cady. Head coach for the Bulldogs is Einar Aronson. His assistants are Paul Meehan and Vito Higgins. And now, the starting 11 for your Pacific Tigers, accompanied tonight by the 10th Field Soccer Club. In goal, a sophomore from Timber Springs, wearing number 0, Chris Goldsmith. Up forward, a sophomore from Elko, number 3, Colin Edwards. A forward, a senior from Kapolei, Hawaii, number 4, Kalei. A defender, a senior from Santa Rosa, number 7, Keenan White. A defender, a senior from West Hills, number 8, Jamie Bench. A forward, a sophomore from Las Vegas, Nevada, number 9, Tristan Blackman. In the midfield, a sophomore from Guadalajara, Mexico, number 10, Andres Ochoa. In the midfield, a sophomore from Kimura, Japan, number 14, Dakuru Wang. In the midfield, a junior from Chula Vista, number 15, Esteban De La Torre. A defender, a senior from Pacific Grove, number 16, Daniel Giovinazzo. And a forward, a sophomore from Sacramento, number 22, Spencer News. The Tigers are coached by Ryan Jordan. He's assisted by Jordan Farrell and Matt Dow. The volunteer assistant is Corey Kendall, and the athletic trainer is Ernie De Los Angeles. We ask now that you please rise, remove your hats and headwear as we honor America with the playing of our national anthem. Thank you.
the quickest substitution in Pacific Soccer history on its way here tonight. Tigers in goal will have Curtis Goldsmith. In front of him, Betancourt, Gallarde, White, Bent, Blackman, Ochoa, Lang, De La Torre, Gio Venazzo, and Spencer Vu. While the Bulldogs in Bevins, Granlund, Kalamar, Chrysler, Ulowitz, and Cavey. As we get set here, temperature about 54 degrees, should be in the low 50s for this whole game. Fog starting to roll in a little bit. Bit of a late arriving crowd, although certainly a lot more people have showed up here in the last 5 or 10 minutes, as the Tigers in the orange will be going from left to right. And as mentioned, the Tigers will quickly probably play the ball over here to us. And they pass it back. And, well, so much for the quick playing it out of bounds. Tigers working around the back, and now they'll boot it forward.
Maybe a little gamesmanship on the part of Coach Jordan and company.
Yeah, they got they have the sub right here at midfield ready, and now it's played out. So perhaps 20, 30 seconds longer than we expected, but now the ball played out, and so that'll do it for senior Jamie Bent, defender from West Hills, California. So,
very nice touch by both teams to allow Jamie to get this senior day send off. Gonzaga very cooperative with that request, and definitely appreciated on his part, I'm sure.
Yeah, at this point especially, it's not a game that for the most part has much of a significant outcome, and they'll throw it back to the goalkeeper. So Ben, after getting the start out in less than a minute. These two teams met twice last season. The Tigers lost both of those games by one goal. A 4-3 game here at Knowles Field that saw the Tigers leading 3-2 for giving up two goals in the final 10 minutes. And then the Tigers lost 1-0 in double overtime in Washington.
That matchup here in Stockton last year was a wild affair. Down 2-1, then up 3-2, then give up two goals over the last 10 minutes of regulation to drop at 4-3 in heartbreaking fashion, but just a wild back-and-forth contest.
Think we're could see one of those again tonight?
Perhaps not that type of game tonight. Gonzaga, one of the defensive leaders in the country, I mean, in the conference for sure, allowing the fewest goals and shots per game allowed in WCC, but also ranking nationally in those categories as well.
And the Tigers haven't been putting in a lot of goals this season. Did score a goal at Portland, although lost 2-1. The Tigers, one win this season was all the way back on September 13th, a game that saw the Tigers score three goals against San Jose State. And outside of that, the Tigers haven't scored more than a goal in a game all season. As that ball goes out of play here in front of us for a Bulldogs throw-in.
Now the first goal tonight, as is often the case in soccer, could be a huge deciding factor. Gonzaga 6-1 this year when scoring first, 0-9-1 when allowing the first goal. Tigers, as you mentioned, the difficulty scoring goals this year, but the last time Tigers did break free and score first at home was the 3-0 results earlier in the year.
And chance here near the top of the box. Try to get around one Tiger defender, and the Tigers will clear it up to Blackman. And the Tigers look to quickly counter, have it on the far side. Cuts back towards the box, knocked away. And now booted up towards midfield, and there's a hard tackle there. Tigers with it. And
Tigers earn a free kick.
So almost a corner kick. In fact, you can hear Ryan Jordan yelling, just like a corner.
Tigers, in terms of size, not a big team, definitely plays a role with some of these set pieces.
A line drive, low cross, headed away. back to the Tigers. And they'll switch sides here to the near side. Back to Giovinazzo.
Last year, the only game that was chilly was the last game, too. I remember.
Back to Giovinazzo, another senior getting the start here tonight on senior night.
In place of Christian Aldama, who is serving a suspension for picking up a red card in the Tigers' last game up in Portland.
So that worked out well for the senior to get the start here tonight. That game in Portland that the Tigers lost 2-1 broke a streak of 7 straight games without a goal for the Tigers. Just 8 goals all season long for the Tigers, so. Quick math says averaging half a goal a game. Gonna have a hard time winning many games when you can't score.
Still so many close games, especially early on in the year. A lot of one goal losses, 1-0s and 2-1s, and that can be a tough mental block to overcome as the season wears on.
Yeah, in fact, Tigers started 0-3. All three of those losses, 2-1 scores, then lost 2-0, 1-3-0, then lost 1-0. So 4 out of the first 5 losses were one-goal games.
And a couple of those with leads, in fact, late in the game, I believe.
Perhaps a case of the Tigers still a young team, just in their second year. After the program got back going last season, which had no seniors on the Tigers team, some seniors here, but.
Definitely part of the growing process, and it would be a good step in the right direction for the Tigers to be able to pull it out tonight and show improvement over last year in the win column and in the points column in the WCC.
Neither side has a shot yet, and we're saying could be a defensive battle, and so far it's looked to be that. Both teams have had a chance or two in the box. Tigers free kick headed away. That ball on the far sideline taken away by the Tigers. And now a whistle will give the free kick to the Bulldogs, quickly taken and switched here to the near side. Nice job there, although played up by Ochoa, goes right to a Bulldog defender who will play it back to the keeper. We'll switch it to the far side. Sergeson will play a long ball forward and unable to connect with the forward, looking for Michelson. Goldsmith comes out and takes it.
And taking a look at Goldsmith's line, he's played more than half of the minutes this year for the Tigers. He split time with Josh Adachi in the cage. He's allowed 16 overall goals on the year, 1.69 goals against average, and has one shutout with a 71.9% save percentage.
And through ball there, offsides flag is up. Yeah, both Goldsmith and Adachi have had lots of saves this season. They've had a lot of shots headed their way as that long ball forward, and Goldsmith will come up and easily catch that one.
You may notice the cast on the right hand of Kalei Gallarde here in the right back position. Coach Ryan Jordan before the game mentioned that he broke his hand in practice yesterday, not keeping him out, at least.
Hey, hard to not see that. And a nice job there to take it away and play it forward. Some space here.
Nearly a nice through ball.
Yeah, able to stay on sides. And then Sergeson able to keep it in play and play it back to the keeper. Yeah. Broken hand in the last practice of the year.
tough break, but at least the hand's not necessarily needed tonight, except for the throw-in. He was a little concerned on how he was going to handle throw-ins if he actually does handle a throw-in.
Yeah, I think the best case for him to handle a throw-in is to leave it there for somebody else. You can take the free kicks, but throw on, let the right midfielder come back and take it. And again, Bulldogs try to play a long ball for, once again, way too far. Here in the 10th minute, scoreless. Final game of the West Coast Conference season here between the Pacific Tigers and the Gonzaga Bulldogs. And a quick pass there goes right to the Tigers. Far side to White. Back to Vu. And that threw ball, and a chance here. Shot knocked away, and that out of bounds. So a good couple chances there for the Tigers and a corner kick.
It's a nice job by Ben White for Gonzaga to break that up, though. It looked like Betancourt might be able to get a pretty clean shot off, but Ben White came through and knocked that away. It's still a corner for the Tigers.
Yeah, that shot would have given Lower more trouble. We saw a free kick from this near spot earlier. This one time, the cross high up, the header towards the back post, headed off the line, and then headed away by Granlin. So a much better kick there on the corner kick, and nice header towards the far post, headed away off the line as that ball is played out of bounds over us. You're talking about the Tigers don't have a lot of height, but they found a head there.
Found a head there, and it looked like he might have had the corner, but a well-headed ball off the line.
And the Tigers coming down in the box. Tigers bench hollering, wanting a penalty kick, but none to come. So, Tigers offense starting to look good here in the last minute or two. For a Bulldogs defense, you were saying one of the top defenses in the West Coast Conference, despite their record. White plays it out wide, and now that whistle goes against the Bulldogs, and the Bulldogs bench hollering at the referee to call the first one. The referee here tonight is Reed Christie. On the flags, Andrew Hanks and Veronica Perez.
Yeah, Gonzaga defensively has only allowed 19 goals all year. Fewest goals in the WCC, fewest shots on goal with 85. Spread over the course of the year, that's not allowing many shots.
Yeah.
Tigers already with 3 shots, 1 on goal in the game.
And quick passes here. Left-footed ball played out wide to the far flag. See if the Tigers will cross it, and they don't. They play it back. Turning. And down goes the Tigers, and no whistle. Fans on the far side end. The Tigers bench both wanting a whistle, but none to come. And once again, the Bulldogs long ball forward, this time finding Granlund, and a whistle there.
Free kick awarded.
Much to the dismay of the crowd, the bench, and Ben Lasky.
Gonzaga seemingly relying on the long ball several times early in the game rather than working it much through the midfield to create some offense.
Yeah, really, their only possession is their back line, passing it back and forth and then just booting it forward, looking for somebody on the break. Bevins to take the free kick, plays it towards the far post, and that'll go well out of play. As a Bulldog tried to catch it as it fell into the sign. So 14th minute, scoreless between the Tigers and the Bulldogs. Tigers have outshot the Bulldogs 3-0. Corner kicks 1-0 in favor of the Tigers as that's headed out for a throw. Creeping up to take the throw, and then that, I thought that was going to go off of Ulowitz, but Bulldogs throw, and now that long ball is going to stay in play. Headed and controlled by the Bulldogs, and now once again, long ball forward from the back, looking for Granlin.
Giovinazzo does slide over to take the throw in instead of Gallardi.
And that throw in will go to the Bulldogs. It'd be interesting to see him try to throw it in with that.
I'm not sure what kind of grip he would get on it.
Long ball to the far side. Now played back. And a bad turnover there by the Bulldogs.
Tigers sending some good numbers forward.
Back to Blackman, who will switch sides and almost passing it right to us. It'll be chased down by Gallardi. Tigers. A little bit of possession here. Now back to Gallardi. And after all that great possession, a bad pass gives it right back to the Bulldogs. Blackman.
Tigers possessing well in the midfield.
Yeah, early on, the Tigers seem to have the better possession of the two teams. They've had the better scoring opportunities as well, although scoreless here in the 17th minute. And that pass back nearly led to a breakaway for the Bulldogs. Yeah, Tigers just content to boot it out of bounds and slow things down.
Tigers will officially honor their seniors with a halftime ceremony. It's going against the grain a little bit. Many teams choosing the pregame ceremony, but Tigers going halftime here tonight.
Yeah, the pregame ceremony for senior day kind of seems to be the normal for all sports at all levels. Although I saw a rare senior day the other day that was actually held after the game, which was nice because we started the game on time.
Yeah, definitely pros and cons with that. You hope that you don't have a senior get hurt or something during a game and miss out on that opportunity, of course. But definitely start a game on time and have a normal pregame routine if you don't have the ceremony before.
Yeah, or the game doesn't go your team's way and all of a sudden you're on the end of a bad loss and all of a sudden now it's time to celebrate and you're not in the most celebrating mood.
Definitely a risk as well.
And chance here for Gonzaga. And good help defense there. And the Tigers able to clear it away. Bulldogs have had a few chances, but do not have a shot yet. Tigers with 3. Scoreless here in the 19th minute as that ball forward looking for Blackman. Offsides flag up once again. Seen a couple offsides called against the Tigers already here. Here, head coach Ryan Jordan encouraging Blackman to make those runs every chance he can get. And that ball just booted out of play, gives the Tigers a throw in. mentioned, low 50s, a little bit of fog, although for the middle of November, it certainly could be a lot worse.
Could be a lot worse.
Or if this game was in 12 hours, tomorrow morning or tomorrow afternoon, we could be bringing out the ponchos. So
I'm not sure we've seen the full effects of El Nino yet.
No. And there's a foul there and still down, and perhaps we will see our first card. No, it's like just a warning.
Yeah, Tigers with a free kick within striking range. Andres Ochoa to take the kick.
Another free kick that really was just a low line drive, easily cleared, and Bulldogs try to quickly counter with possession at midfield, although given back, and the Tigers look to quickly counter. Nice ball there. Chance here for the Tigers, and it's a goal!
A great touch by Gaku Leng to finish that off the pass from Colin Betancourt.
So there it is, the big first goal of the night. Gaku Leng with the goal. Tigers capitalizing off of the turnover. A nice through ball play to Leng, and Leng with his third goal of the season, and the Tigers lead 1-0.
Yeah, Livermore came out of the box, tried to cut that off, but Gaku got there just in time to put a touch past him. Nice goal by Gaku.
So the sophomore from Japan, and the Tigers with the 1-0 lead. And we're talking about how the Bulldogs' defense doesn't give up a lot of shots or goals, and really the Tigers have well-deserved probably first goal, as they've had the better scoring opportunities. They've looked dangerous on the counter, and so
overall, good possession through the midfield, a couple opportunities early on, and I would agree, definitely a deserved goal.
Yeah, fortunate the free kick wasn't the best. The line drive that was cleared, and then Bulldogs just gave it right back. And Tigers, really both sides have looked for the quick counters and long balls, and nice ball there, and a nice touch by Leng over the goalkeeper who was late to charge out and try to get to that one. So far, so good here tonight. Yeah, that long ball nowhere near Tiger into the hands of the goalkeeper, Livermore. So, Tigers' goals in back-to-back games for the first time in quite some time, as the one-handed Gallarde plays it down the line to Blackman, and he hasn't knocked out a play, although they're going to say a throw-in for the Bulldogs, quickly taken. A lot of contact there. No foul, and Tigers able to clear it back towards midfield, and that's a bad pass there, giveaway. Sigurdsson plays it out wide to the far side. And that ball bounces. Nearly had the Tigers on a break once again. Well, so far, good mood at halftime for that senior celebration.
Yeah, good mood for sure.
Midway through the first half, Tigers leading 1-0. 21st minute goal by Gaku Leng. His third of the season. Leads the Tigers now with 3 goals on the season.
I really have to give head coach Ryan Jordan and his staff a lot of credit the way they've handled the team this year. It's a young team. They had some really disappointing close results that didn't go our favor early on, but still competing throughout the year, even when the results these last couple weeks haven't gone well. You can tell they're still competing, still trying to improve. It's all a process that Ryan Jordan's instilling in them, and hopefully the dividends we'll see in the next couple of years.
Yeah, it's frustrating to lose the game after game, but they've been playing hard, losing 1-0, 2-0. You know, I mean, really, outside of a one bad game at UC Davis in September. All the games this season have been decided by 3 goals or less, so just the scoring hasn't been there. Although it's been here tonight so far, as the Tigers lead 1-0. That ball eventually controlled by the Bulldogs here on the near side. A left-footed ball towards the far post, headed into the air by the Tigers, now bouncing. The Bulldogs get it, looking to turn in the box. Tigers defense will clear. A little possession right back to the Bulldogs, and body spilling on the far side. It'll be a throw in for the Bulldogs. And one of the Bulldogs there kind of took a swing. And yeah, see if the ref has a word. Is can't see the number as he's walking back towards the midfield, but we got a late swing. And now ref telling him enough. Throw in, knocked down. Tigers try to clear, but out of play for another Bulldogs throw-in. Bulldogs with it near the far corner, looking to try to get off a cross. Turns, knocked away by the Tigers. And now Blackman plays the ball forward. And Tigers look to quickly counter. Heading towards the far corner, trying to turn and help defense by the Bulldogs, takes it away. And as we've seen all night so far, they'll play a long ball forward. Now
foul behind the play.
Yeah. I guess no advantage there, so they'll bring it back for the free kick.
Only the 6th home game of the year for the Tigers here on Senior Day. Very road-heavy schedule, and it was that way last year, too. You know, head coach Ryan Jordan had some challenges in scheduling as a new program early on, but next year's schedule, from what I've told, is very home-heavy with a lot of return games off contract, so that'll be good to have more games out here.
Seems like we had a lot, not only for the men's soccer team this season, but a lot of the teams have been road-heavy starts to the season.
True. Women's basketball with its first 6 or 7 non-conference games on the road. Women's volleyball only played conference games at home.
Yeah, they spent the first months on the road. And that, you know, the men's water polo and women's water polo also don't seem to play as many home games as they do road games, although some of those it's tournaments back in Southern California. But we need to get more teams to come here to Stockton. Tigers leading 1-0 here in the 27th minute. So about the 7th or the 8th home game, so not quite half the season has been on the road. Tigers had one stretch on the road for 4 straight.
Opened the year with 4 straight, the trip back to Nebraska, then a tournament at UNLV. Back here for 1, then back on the road for 2. So actually 2 separate stretches of 4 road games.
Yeah, because that Utah Valley game wasn't neutral or on the road, basically. Switch to the far side. Passes eventually knocked out of play on the far side for a Tigers throw-in. I think after tonight, it kind of puts the end on the first third of the sports season here at Pacific. Water polo played their final home game earlier this afternoon.
Women's soccer wrapped up, and still a couple home matches for women's volleyball.
That's true. There are 3 more, I want to say, including a game or two this coming week. And offside's flag is up once again.
I believe it's the Portland-Gonzaga duo coming down for action here at Spano Center next weekend.
Yeah, I believe Thursday is the giving out the camouflage shirts for their first 200 fans.
Salute to the military knights.
But yeah, I guess that would, once the women's volleyball season comes to an end after their three games, then it's kind of, it's basketball season.
Basketball till after the first of the year, then we get the spring sports coming in February.
I know the one of the favorite times here is always when all the sports are overlapping. That's always a lot of fun. Tigers leading 1-0 as we're into the 30th minute here at Knowles Field. Tigers leading off a 21st minute goal from Gaku Lang.
So a couple of players starting to warm up for Gonzaga. Potential subs coming in a little bit.
Yeah, we haven't seen a sub outside of the one in the first minute for Jamie Bent, who got the start on senior night, and the ball got passed around a little bit before it played out for him to be taken out without risking further injury to his eye. Not a surprise, I don't think, that we haven't seen any subs. I mean, it's a little cold if you're sitting here watching, but really it's a nice night if you're out there running around playing. And free kick chance here, although almost from the sideline. And that's a nice ball towards the back post, headed out by the Tigers. And chased down and knocked out for a Bulldogs throw-in. White with the long throw in into the box, headed away by the Tigers, but right to the Bulldogs, Granlin.
The Bulldogs will get that throw as well.
And nice job there by Ochoa to take it away. Fancy footwork there, still with it. And now a nice ball played. No flag, and able to make the save is the goalkeeper Lowermore. So some nice footwork there by Ochoa in the long ball.
And Gaku Lang with another nice run to get free and have an opportunity.
Yeah, the Tigers' long balls have certainly seemed to be a lot more dangerous than the Bulldogs, and now there's a collision and the clock is being stopped.
And that will open the book for Andres Ochoa, first yellow card of the match.
So things have become physical, and finally our first yellow card of the night. Tigers have outshot the Bulldogs 5-0, leading 1-0 here in the 32nd minute as long ball towards the back post, and it's headed, and it's in. Wow. So I couldn't quite see who headed it in.
Jalen Chrysler will pick up credit for that goal. Header off the back post, off a set piece.
So after the foul and the yellow card to Ochoa, Granlin takes the free kick, and that was a nice free kick to the far post, headed in past Goldsmith, and so we are tied at one here in the 32nd minute.
Bulldogs take advantage of their first shot on goal of the game.
I guess if you're not going to get many shots, make sure the ones you do get count. That one finished to tie it up. So first 30-plus minutes, really all the Tigers, but that advantage is all gone. It's tied here in the 32nd minute as that ball played will find the hands of Goldsmith.
And a couple Gonzaga subs prepping to check in.
See if they come over and try to check in with us. That ball, couple hopper right into the hands of Goldsmith. Ball booted forward and it's going to bounce out of play, and that'll allow the substitutions to come in.
It'll be Alec Johnson and Jake Kemp checking in for the Bulldogs.
Tigers also with the substitution getting ready to come in. As Cervantes will come in for the Tigers, replacing Colin Betancourt.
Christo Michelson and Nick Ulowitz were the two Bulldogs who checked out in that substitution.
So, first non-first minute substitutions here in the 34th minute. Lee gives it up and now gets it back. Tigers unable to take it away. And the Bulldogs will play it all the way back to their keeper, Lowermore. Lowermore's been busy. Does have two saves on the night. Was unable to get out and keep Lang from scoring the game's first goal, but tied at one here. Just over 10 minutes to go in the first half, and we throw in for the Bulldogs on the far side.
Bulldogs have only conceded more than one goal four times this year, so it will be a tough task for the Tigers to be able to strike again.
And the Tigers have scored more than one goal in a game just once this season. So something's gonna give if Tigers are gonna end the season on a positive note. A long ball forward there. A nice drive there by Blackman to shield off the defender and now has it near the near corner. Able to get near the end line. Cuts it back. Over to the far side. Now back to De La Torre. Larde. Towards the top of the box. See if the Tigers can get off a shot here. Kind of chip pass ends up in the hands of the goalkeeper. And once again, Bulldogs the long ball forward, headed by the Tigers and now controlled. Ochoa gets it to Blackman and he gets knocked down for a foul. Tigers will just play it short and now switch sides of the field. And unforced turnover really there on the far side, out of play for a throw-in.
Yeah, a little bit foggier, a little harder to see over on that far side.
Yeah, though, I was mentioning to you a game earlier this week on TV, a Euro qualifier, Ireland and somebody, and you literally could not see anything on the TV that was going on. You know, compared to that game, it's a sunny day here. The commentators were talking about how if it got any worse, as long as the referee can see each goal, it would continue. And that ball in the box, a dangerous cross there. Fortunately, right at the feet of a Tiger defender, able to clear it near midfield.
If it gets too foggy for our camera on the near side, we can always bring out the drone and have it follow the ball around the field.
That would be something. Maybe we should get Corey Crawley on it. Break out a new toy for the second half. As through ball there, flag down. Although the late flag as a slow offside call there. You know, nearly another great ball. but the late flag against Blackman, almost a flag came up after Blackman was shooting it into the net. I want to say at least the fourth or fifth offsides flag against the Tigers here in the first half. And referee giving an excuse on why his offside call was delayed. I think he said 10 was on and 9 was off, which is why he was waiting to see if the ball was played by Blackman.
Camden Riley is set to check in next opportunity for the Tigers after this set piece from the Bulldogs.
Yeah, the redhead that is easy to recognize when he's on the field. And line drive free kick there, headed away by the Tigers and over the end line. So it'll be a corner kick here for the Bulldogs.
Another dangerous entry from Granlund on that free kick.
Yeah, he was fired up after getting the assist on that goal as he had taken the spill and was not very happy. First corner kick, they take it short. And now the ball low in the box. Tigers will clear it out. Looking to try to quickly counter. A lot of contact there. And they'll bring it back and call the foul against the Tigers. 6 minutes to go here in the first half. Tied at one. 21st minute goal by Lang gave the Tigers a lead, but 11 minutes later, Jalen Chrysler, the header to tie it. And it's a bit of a dangerous ball into the box. Still in the box, headed towards goal. And cleared. See if the Tigers are able to find somebody on the counter. And that ball just behind Cervantes. And once again, long ball forward ends up in the hands of Goldsmith. Set it down and then boot it forward. And initial header by the Bulldogs, although it goes to Ochoa. And now Blackman with it back to De La Torre. Gives it up and gets it back, and now on the far side, the Tigers will bring it back here to the near side, and they do. Velarde to Ochoa with some room. The left-footed shot, line drive right at the goalkeeper. Good idea, although that ball would have needed some more movement on it to get by the goalkeeper lower more. And players falling all over the place. Tigers with it. Gallarde towards the far post. Knocked down and now booted out of play. And that'll allow the Tigers to make the substitution.
Camden Riley checking in for Spencer Vu. It's a nice overlap by Gallarde on that last possession and a nice entry into Blackman, just not able to get it directed on goal, but the Tigers still get the opportunity here in the offensive half.
Yeah, we've seen the Tigers have looked very dangerous at times. They've had more scoring opportunities than the Bulldogs, but the Bulldogs scored on their lone shot of the first half to tie it at one here in the 42nd minute. Nice job there to chest it down and quickly play a ball forward, although that's going to roll out of play right in front of us.
We'll give us a Pacific throw. A lot of work for Giovinazzo playing center back, but also having to handle these throw-ins.
Yeah. All although I'm sure he doesn't mind getting some good playing time here tonight, in part because of the red card. Now the Tigers a chance here. The cross towards the center and loose, and the Tigers slipped almost in the box, and eventually the ball wound up in the hands of the goalkeeper.
Looked like a little bit of pinball down there, and then the goalkeeper was able to corral it before Tigers took advantage of that opportunity.
Just over 2 minutes to go here in the first half. See if the Tigers can have a little possession here and try to get one more chance before half to retake the lead, as it's played all the way back to Goldsmith. Well, left-footed boot forward, initial header by the Tigers, and then the Bulldogs' back line will just boot it forward like they have most of the night so far. Battle in the far corner, and nice job there by the Bulldogs to draw the corner. Can't quite tell who that was that won the corner, but nice job to turn it towards the end line and force the Tigers to knock it out. So
looks like it'll be Colton Cavey taking handed it off, actually. Both Cavey and Ben White.
Yeah, end up taking it short. And now into the deep box, and eventually cleared back towards midfield. Back to the goalkeeper. Forty seconds to go here in the first half. Tied at one. As Lowermore will do a long boot forward, headed by the Bulldogs towards the box, and they're going to call the foul on the Tigers. So a chance here for the Bulldogs to
a last-ditch free kick
attempt. Yeah, Tigers not helping out and let the ball go in the net. Made the Bulldogs chase it down. 10 seconds to go in the half. Quickly played into the box, and that header will go wide. So that'll do it for the first 45 minutes of play. The Tigers got a goal from Gaku Leng to lead 1-0 in the 21st minute, but the Bulldogs answered back. Jalen Chrysler, a hitter in the 32nd minute, has us tied at one. So we'll take a break for halftime and be back with the second half. You're watching Pacific Soccer on the W.TV. Welcome back to Knowles Field as we get set for the second half between the Pacific Tigers and the Gonzaga Bulldogs. As after 45 minutes, we're tied at one. Kaku laying a goal in the 21st minute. Gave the Tigers the lead, but then Jalen Chrysler answered with a goal for the Bulldogs in the 32nd minute to tie things up.
Take a look at halftime stats and total shots in the game. Pacific leading by a count of 6-2. Gaku Lang with two shots. Andres Ochoa one, Tristan Blackman one, and Kurt Kapelhoff. Of those, four shots on target, two by Gaku, one by Andres Ochoa, one by Tristan Blackman. For Gonzaga, two shots in the game, one on goal, and that resulted in the goal by Jalen Chrysler back in the 32nd minute. Corner kicks, Gonzaga with two, Pacific with one, fouls, Gonzaga with five, Pacific with 11, and saves, Gonzaga with three by goalkeeper Chris Lowermore. One yellow card so far in the game, picked up by Andres Ochoa for the Tigers in the 32nd minute that resulted in that free kick and the goal by the Bulldogs.
Yeah, the result in the free kick, the first shot and the first goal for the Bulldogs as we're underway here in the second half. Paul Meiskens along with the one and only Mike Delgetti as here in the second half, the Bulldogs will be going from left to right while the Tigers in the orange tops going from right to left as it's the final game of West Coast Conference play. Tigers looking for their first win in league play while the Bulldogs looking for their second. Mentioned a win here for the Tigers would allow the Tigers to finish in sixth place in league play. So while neither team playing for the West Coast Conference Championship, both want to end the season on a bright spot or a bright note with a win here on a cold and foggy Saturday night.
Tigers took a few minutes at halftime to honor their four departing seniors, so we'll intermix a few facts about our seniors throughout the second half. Start with Jamie Bent, who in 2 years played six games this year before an injury ended his season before tonight, playing in a brief minute at the very beginning to have that senior day experience. Last year appeared in 17 games, including a game-winning goal against Dominican in the Tigers' first ever game since the program was resurrected and an assist in a win over UC Santa Cruz. Jamie's graduating in December with a business major and a double concentration in marketing and finance.
Yeah, in fact, I remember that goal by Jamie Bent. I was here just watching in the crowd of many others, and it was in extra time. I want to say
double overtime. Yes.
Yeah, and he finished it near the near post, and it was Tigers' first win, although it was an exhibition, so I guess technically it didn't count as a win. But
still one of the best goal celebrations we've had out here at Knowles Field since the program's come back.
Yeah, and the crowd was going crazy. It was quite the atmosphere there and moment. And unfortunately, Bent's last moment here tonight, the brief appearance with the injury, getting the start on senior night before being quickly subbed out. As the Tigers work it up on the far side. As shown by the numbers, Tigers really outplayed the Bulldogs in the first half, but it's tied, and now we're going to have a penalty kick opportunity as the ball just bounced up and off the hands. Great chance here in the 48th minute for the Tigers to go back in front.
Looks like it might be Keenan White coming up to take the PK. Keenan White without a career goal to this point through his 2 years. He'll step up to the spot.
Well, the goalkeeper, Lowermore, taking his time to get set. Hands high for the PK. And it's in. So there's his first career goal. And the Tigers back in front here in the 48th minute. So the senior from Santa Rosa with the goal.
And the first time the Tigers have scored more than one goal since back in September the 13th against San Jose State. So hopefully the second goal will be enough for the Tigers to See through to sixth place here in the WCC standings.
The Tigers are undefeated this season when scoring more than one goal.
There's your stat of the night.
But we talked about that. The Tigers had only scored more than one goal in a game once. But you can say Gonzaga doesn't allow more than a goal a game, hardly at all. So Tigers with the opening goal of the second half, leading 2-1. So, talked about the senior Jamie Benton, his goal in his first game here at Knowles Field, and then having to have just a brief appearance here, but there's a senior moment for Keenan White.
And we'll take our next look at a Tiger senior, Kalei Gallarde, started every game this year. He's third on the team in minutes for the year. Last season, he played in 15 games, scoring a game winner in Pacific's first Division I win in the new era of the program. That was a road victory down in Cal Poly. And he also had an assist against Gonzaga later in the year last year. Kalei is scheduled to graduate in the spring with a degree in health, exercise, and sports sciences.
There's a look at one of the Tiger seniors that was honored at halftime. I like the confidence shown by Ben Lasky before that PK, announcing that this would be Keenan White's first career goal.
He had confidence in the senior.
And giveaway there, and shot looking for the far corner goes a little wide. So just the third shot of the night for Gonzaga. They were held without a shot for the first 31 minutes before the goal to tie it up at one.
They still just have the one shot on target, though, and that was the one they converted. The header off the free kick that tied it up in the 32nd.
And when I was playing, Coach always wanted to keep shooting. He figured every five or six shots should hopefully turn into a goal. Well, it certainly helps when those shots are on goal versus off goal. Yes. Vu with it. Goes to the far side. And that ball roll over the end line for a goal kick. Shots 7-3 in favor of the Tigers. Saves 3-0 in favor by the Bulldogs. Corner kicks 2-1 in favor of Gonzaga. Although in the column that means the most, the Tigers leading 2-1 in goals scored. Yes. A lot of contact on the far side. Possession controlled by the Tigers. And got the crowd going crazy on the far side. And now played forward. Ball here on the near side in front of us to Kemp. Came in as a sub late in the first half. Attempted to give it a go there. Given away, and now the Tigers will play it back to Goldsmith, who will blast it with his left foot forward. Bulldogs able to keep it in play on the far side, but once again, a long ball forward goes right to the Tigers. Here's Lang with it, plays it. And there's tons of contact there. And the foul is going to go against the Tigers. There's a lot of people shaking their heads wondering.
Needless to say, the coaching staff did not agree with that call either.
The fans and I think the fans and coaching staff are in agreement there that they disagree. Long ball there will go all the way to the feet of Goldsmith, who will take his time, and eventually he will pick it up after being challenged, and now he'll run it back towards the near side towards us, and we'll roll it. Ball played for it, headed by Lang. Possession controlled back by the Tigers. Kapelhoff, he came in for Bent in the first minute. Lang will play a ball forward, knocked away by the Bulldogs, back to the keeper, and he'll boot it out right near us. And offsides.
I'll take a look at our third of four Tiger seniors. Oh, we have a break here with a defensive free kick. Daniel Givinazzo served as president of the Pacific Men's Soccer Club team for 2 years before the varsity team came on board last year. He's played in 8 games, logging 135 minutes and counting tonight. Daniel's a member of Pacific Student Investment Fund through the business school and also a member of the WCC Commissioner's Honor Roll. He's a business administration major with a concentration in finance from Pacific Grove, California. Getting the bulk of his action here tonight, might go a full 90.
Yeah, why not? Trying to get the seniors some playing time on senior night, and also end the season on a good note with a win. And right now the Tigers leading 2-1 here in the 55th minute. Kemp plays it forward, and it goes right to the Tigers defense. Played forward, Vu now will play it forward. Finds its way to Betancourt, and now Blackman, a chance here, and a nice job by the goalkeeper, Lowermore, to come out and cut off his angle. Eighth shot of the night for the Tigers. Kapelhoff and Ochoa pass it back and forth, and now Ochoa will switch sides of the field. And there's a foul that'll give the Tigers a free kick. We saw one card in the first half. I'd be surprised if we don't see another card or two here in the second, as things have gotten very physical as it's played into the box. And
be a corner kick for the Tigers.
Looks like it'll be a right-footed outswinger from the far corner. And it's a line drive near the near post. Back out. And a chance here to get a cross off. And that ball kind of just hammers off of a teammate and somehow gets to the Tigers in the box. Shot deflected. Still loose near the top of the box, and a Tiger half volley attempt there, falling down. Slide tackled out for a throw in on the far side. And now referee's gonna have a word with both players there. Knocked out again for another Bulldogs throw-in. And that whistle goes against the Tigers. Free kick. Good taken by Bevins. Kind of similar location from the first half that saw the Bulldogs play it near the far post and headed in for a goal. And headed by the Bulldogs. And knocked out there for a corner kick.
Granlund will leave it for Ben White out there in the corner.
if they take it short. The Tigers have a couple players there ready for the short corner, and they'll play it into the box near the near post, head it out. Bulldogs still with it. And the foul there goes against the Tigers. So it'll be a free kick here, similar to a corner, although a bit better of an angle. And now we're going to have a stoppage. They're going to move them back.
I need the vanishing spray.
Oh, that would be good. Why don't we have that? As it's headed away. Oh, and that volley goes right off. And he gets right back up. I don't think I would have gotten up there quickly. Towards the far post, down in the box. Bulldogs, chance here, shot deflected by a Tiger. The follow-up shot over the top. So, several chances there for the Bulldogs in the last couple minutes.
Go ahead and round out our senior class. We're waiting for the Tiger goal kick. Fourth and final senior of the year, Keenan White, played in all but one game during those 2 years as a Tiger, starting all but one of those games. Formidable leader on the back line and scored his first career goal tonight, which was such breaking news that it wasn't even in the senior script at halftime. Keenan's a history major from Santa Rosa.
And a little over 30 minutes away from hopefully his first game-winning goal of his college career. And he fouled there, and the Bulldog player certainly is making the most of this foul.
Collectively, though, this is a very special senior class to be a part of. First group to move on from the newly resurrected program. 10, 15 years from now, this group of four can look back, hopefully with a lot of pride at how the program continues to grow.
As a dangerous ball there towards the back post, headed out, and that'll be a corner kick. And yeah, they can look back and be like, you know, we were a part of it when it really got started and back going. So here in the 61st minute. And a high ball towards the back post. And the foul called there against the Bulldogs. And this time it's the Bulldogs bench unhappy with the whistle going against them. Shots right now 9-5 in favor of the Tigers. Lowermore 4 saves. Goldsmith has not had to make a save yet here tonight. The sliding tackle ball played forward right to the Bulldogs. They'll quickly play it forward, and Tigers now will boot it to midfield. And now Vu, with a little bit of room, will play it forward to Blackman, and goalkeeper coming out. A nice job, similar to the goal the Tigers scored in the first half. Well, this time Lowermore was able to get out and stop Blackman from adding to the Tigers' lead.
Tigers have had a few of those through balls that has forced Lowermore to make the decision, stay back, come forward. He's come forward pretty consistently. Got beat on Gaku's goal in the first half, but a nice job there on Tristan's attempt.
So, substitution here for the Tigers. Cervantes in, replacing Colin Betancourt. Throwing was right to the Bulldogs, and as we've seen, they waste no time playing a long ball forward. Possession controlled by the Tigers, and now we'll played to Kappelhoff. Oh, the Bulldogs win it right back. Back to Bevins. Daggers trying to apply the pressure and force a turnover in the back. Although, nice run there. Ball goes right to Gallardi. And there's bodies flying all over the place, and that foul goes against the Bulldogs. Lang not quickly getting up here. And now they're going to stop the clock. Lang scored his third goal of the season back in the 21st minute, which gave the Tigers a 1-0 lead.
Looks like he will be able to stay on the field as the trainer was not required to check on him.
And the Tigers decided to quickly take the free kick and play it short. That ball nearly taken away. Dangerous play there by the Bulldogs. Still just the one yellow card on the night, but more have to be coming. That's the first half, we saw 16 fouls between the two teams, and that ball into the box. Looking for Blackman, and they're going to call Blackman with the foul. Good pressure there, and Tigers able to take it away. Blackman with it here on the counter. Ball played through. And the slide tackle there. And they're going to stop the clock. And a yellow card has been given.
Alec Johnson of Gonzaga picks up the yellow.
Yeah, so they let the advantage play on, and then after the ball knocked away, stopped play, and brought it back in the yellow card to Alec Johnson. So there's our second yellow card of the night.
And a free kick in a pretty dangerous position. Looks to be just outside the 18-yard box. Maybe from about 25 yards or so.
Yeah, five-man wall for the Bulldogs here. As De La Torre to take it low into the wall. And Tigers chase it down on the far side. Hoping the wall was going to jump up and he's going to be able to get it through the wall and off the wall. Now the Bulldogs a chance here with numbers. Although Tigers defense quickly closing and now back, and there's the offside flag.
Yeah, he was in the offside position well before that ball was played.
Tigers leading 2-1 here in the 66th minute. Yes, that ball knocked out for a Tigers throw-in. Taken away by the Bulldogs. Oh, nearly taken away there by Cervantes. Couple heads. Eventually, Blackman with it here on the near side, battling. And that's knocked out for a throw in right in front of us.
He had a chance to play that one.
I a little slow. Had my hands in my pocket. Bit of a cool night here in Stockton, low 50s. Little breeze, little fog, although not too bad, all things considered.
Rain on the way, but not during the game. Won't be till early morning hours.
Yeah, if the rain's going to come, let it all be tomorrow when we're home. As there's no games here at Pacific tomorrow of any sport. Although, be a busy week of sports.
It'll be a busy week. Home volleyball, have some basketball. Men's water polo down at the MPSF tournament.
As that long ball forward's going to roll out of play. Yeah, certainly will be exciting. The men's water polo team ranked number 2 in the nation.
Got that 2 seed locked up going into tournament play. They'll await the winner of the 7-10 game in the quarterfinals on Friday down at USC's campus, host site for the MPSF tournament.
Yeah. And talking with Pat Donlin, who does the water polo games with me, it's hard not to almost feel like it's a guarantee the Tigers will be in the NCAA tournament, but they'd really have to fall apart over the next week or so to not.
Yeah, the interesting factor will be number of times that the Tigers have played those top 4 other teams in the country, because we did not play in the NorCal tournament, so missed out on a couple of head-to-heads with the Pac-12 schools there. 1-2 against Cal, 1-0 against Stanford, 1-0 against USC, 0-1 against UCLA, all entering play at the MPSF. So we'll see how those head-to-head matchups shake out. If it comes down to a 2-3 seed, 3-4 seed, that head-to-head's going to come into play.
Yeah. Well, you like to think if the Tigers can make it to the MPSF championship game, that probably means that...
That would remove most doubt.
And by being the 2 seed, they're going to get to avoid UCLA until the finals. So, another game against Stanford or Cal or USC likely. As the corner kick from the far side. Knocked away, and the Bulldogs try to quickly counter. And that through ball just booted clear over the far sideline for a throw in.
A couple subs checking in for Gonzaga here in the 69th minute. It will be Connor Urata and Zach Hudson coming on for the Bulldogs. Dennis Calamar and Colton Cavey checking out.
Yeah, the Tigers trying to hold on for the win here as that ball will go out of play for a goal kick. Will you be headed to Southern California for water polo?
For Saturday and Sunday, so the semifinal date and championship Sunday. Tomorrow's actually a big day in MPSF water polo. Have the rivalry games with UCLA, USC, and also Stanford, Cal, both those on the Pac-12 network. Give them a plug.
Yeah, although if UCLA loses, we would finish tied for first in the league record, but because of UCLA's head-to-head win, we would still be the number 2 seed. It's now foul there. We'll give the Tigers a nice free kick opportunity.
All right, UCLA's locked into the 1, we're locked into the 2, Cal's locked into the 3. I think USC and Stanford, depending on those results tomorrow with the 4-5, they'll probably end up playing each other in the 4-5 game, but just who gets the 4, who gets the 5.
Who gets listed first? And who's this?
The dark caps, light caps.
Yeah. Well, just under 20 minutes to go here. Tigers play it towards the back post, headed away by the Bulldogs. I think you should work on getting the West Coast Conference to add the magic spray to the referee's arsenal.
Not sure why not. If it's a budget thing, we can approve that.
You wouldn't think those little cans of magic of spray would be too expensive. It certainly makes things easy of don't put the ball past here and don't move past this line for the wall. Although I've seen a few soccer games where it's been kind of fun. The guys try to move it out of the way because it bubbles up. And played back here. Now out wide to Kappelhoff. Blackman. Vu. And De La Torre out wide. Some nice possession here by the Tigers, although that pass to Vu knocked away. It looked like that was a handball, and it is. Tigers leading 2-1 here in the 72nd minute. We tied it 1 after 45 minutes of play, and Keenan White with the penalty kick goal in the 48th minute. Right now, the game winner. There's another foul in front of us. Foul against Lang. Scored the Tigers' first goal. Vu, the one-man wall here. Ball played along the grass, and now that long-range shot goes well high over the top. A couple substitutions getting ready for the Bulldogs. Goldsmith not in that big of a hurry to take this goal kick as it's headed by the Bulldogs. And it's again a long ball this time to the far side, and it unable to keep it in play. It'll be a throw in for the Tigers.
A throw in for Gonzaga overruled by the referee.
Yeah, so that'll allow the Bulldogs to make their substitutions.
Looks like there was a yellow card shown to a Tiger as well. Daniel Giovinazzo, who picks up the yellow card for the Tigers, checking into the game for Gonzaga. It's Christo Michelson returning to action, and Dustin Ferger checking in for the first time.
So there's our third yellow of the night, second on the Tigers. So Giovinazzo, he's made the most of his big playing time here tonight, now in the books with the yellow card. The senior from Pacific Grove. Couple headers back and forth on the far side. Possession briefly with the Bulldogs. And that ball played forward finds its way to Vu. Vu, a nice touch there to Lang. And a big slide tackle there and no foul. And a few people over here wondering for a card, but not even a foul was called. Seen some interesting no calls here tonight.
That one, it looked like he did not play the ball, but we play on.
Yeah, he played the ball after playing a lot of the body. Really almost looked like a kind of a professional foul to slow down the break, to take, you know, you'd see that to slow the break, take the yellow card and slow things down. Not even a foul was called. Ball into the box, easily into the hands of Goldsmith.
Tigers preparing another substitution at their next opportunity.
Header by the Bulldogs goes to the Tigers, but possession right back to Gonzaga. Ball finds its way to Blackman, nicely chested down. Tigers a chance here with a bit of a 3-on-3. And Blackman didn't see that, the Bulldog defender coming on there to knock it away. Nice back heel there, and then the pass a little too far finds its way to Lang. Blackman over to Vu. Vu turns in traffic. Nice turn again there by Vu. Gets it to Kappelhoff. Gets it back, and then it's knocked out of play, and that'll allow the Tigers to make some substitutions.
Camden Riley and Colin Betancourt both returning to action for the Tigers. Tristan Blackman and Gaku Lang coming off.
So here in the 76th minute, Tigers leading 2-1. looking to end West Coast Conference play with their first West Coast Conference win of the season. A win that would allow the Tigers to finish in sixth place. That ball finds its way to Kappelhoff. And towards the top of the box. And now gets it back, trying to find some room to get off his shot, and it's knocked out for a throw-in. Throw-in played back, and that'll be a Bulldogs throw-in. And that's a silly foul there. By Vu.
We'd like to try to start that back in play about 10 yards ahead of where the foul occurred. Just over 12 minutes left. Tigers still holding an edge in shots, 11-6.
And Goldsmith hasn't had to make a save yet tonight. Come out and caught a few balls that were played into the box. Ball on the other end. Five saves by Lowermore. And he's had a pretty good night. Really can't fault him much for the two goals, one of which on the penalty kick. Tigers look to counter there, knocked away, and Lowermore comes out and will boot it forward. Couple headers, possession eventually to Gonzaga, although again a quick ball played forward goes to the Tigers. They'll play it back to Goldsmith, who will play it forward looking for Vu, headed by the Bulldogs, but right to Kappelhoff. Nice play there by Cervantes, and
offside.
Well,
play continued, but the offside flag was up, so it'll be back to Gonzaga on the offside.
Yeah, and the Tiger bench just went crazy when that flag went up. We don't have the best angle, but certainly didn't look like a offside to me, and a chance here for the Bulldogs headed out and will be a goal kick.
Tigers entering similar territory as the home game against the Bulldogs last year. Up a goal with about 10 minutes left.
Just had to go and mention that, didn't you?
Well, you're more experienced, though. Looking for a different outcome than what happened here last year.
Yeah. You mentioned both of the two games between these two teams last year were one-goal games. And like we might have another one-goal game here, although Tigers looking to be on the winning end of it for the first time as handball there against Keenan White. And now the clock is being stopped, and hey, it's another yellow.
Yellow card to Julio Cervantes for time wasting.
So the fourth yellow card of the night, third card of the second half. The Bulldogs goalkeeper almost at midfield here. Ball played towards the far post, headed by the Tigers towards the far sideline, and that's knocked out, and that'll be a throw-in for the Tigers.
It's kind of a needless yellow card on the part of Cervantes, but at the same time, we don't have the same issues with yellow card accumulation that we would earlier in the year.
Yeah, you're not going to have to worry about missing another game since this is it. But yeah, a time-wasting yellow card penalty is pretty light way to earn one. Into the box, and Kappelhoff will play it clear. Kind of a whiff there. And the Tigers with it. And chance here, and guess what? The offside flag was up. Although the referee waved it away. That's headed out and causes some excitement here. Ben Lasky saving the life of Curran. Nice job there by Kappelhoff to play it. And goes off of Gonzaga, so that'll allow the Tigers to make some substitutions.
Kaku Lang and Tristan Blackman returning to the action for the Tigers. It'll be Julio Cervantes and Spencer Vu checking out.
As we're here in the 82nd minute, Tigers leading 2-1. White chases that down, plays it back, and then Tigers just play a long ball forward there, looking for Betancourt. And lots of contact there, and they're going to call that one against Betancourt.
Betancourt's work rate has been pretty impressive tonight. He's been all over in the attacking third of the field, and then even we've seen him down on the defensive end blocking shots. He's hustling everywhere he goes and putting forth a good effort tonight.
Yeah, you talked about the Tigers, despite their record and some disappointing close losses, they've been battling tough all season. It really would be a real nice way to end the season here if they can hold on here in the final 8 minutes to pick up this 2-1 win, as that ball is played out for a throw-in near the near corner. Long throw-in will go out of play. So Tigers will take their time for this goal kick. Yes. We near 7 minutes to go on a chilly night. Well, I think the fog's
it's actually cleared up a bit.
Yeah. I was going to go, has it gotten less foggy, or did I just wipe my glasses off? As that ball played towards the far corner, and the Bulldogs are able to keep it in play, chase it down. Knocked out for a throw-in on the far side, quickly taken by the Bulldogs. Over here on the near side. Turning towards the end line and headed. Bulldogs have it at the top of the box, played back. Low ball played towards the box, deflected. And there's a big spill there. Foul against the Bulldogs will allow the Tigers to let some time tick off the clock.
85th minute. Tigers hoping Keenan White's 48th minute penalty kick will hold up.
Header there, taken by the Bulldogs. Played for it. Ball pinballing around. Tigers, though, now with possession. Back to Goldsmith, and he will just hit a line drive towards midfield. Headed there by Gallarde. Blackman tried to hit it by the Bulldog defender and chase it back. Nice move here by the Bulldogs into the box. Line drive towards the far post. And fortunately, no one there to tap it in. And now we're going to have the clock stopped. Bulldog down right in front of goal.
Crossed in there by Grandland, and then Can't see who that is quite yet, but diving, sliding attempt to try to get a foot on it in the box. And a little bit of collision with Goldsmith. Goldsmith seems to come up okay.
Yeah, fortunate there for the Tigers. The dangerous ball towards the back post, needing any sort of redirection. Under 5 minutes to go. Tigers leading 2-1, looking for their first win in West Coast Conference play to end the 2015 season. First senior night. And that ball will roll all the way over the end line for a goal kick for the Bulldogs. And that'll allow the Tigers to make a substitution.
Spencer Vu checking back in for the Tigers, replacing Colin Betancourt. Gonzaga also looking to take advantage of this opportunity to make a sub. And the Bulldogs will get their substitution in as well. Braden Sullivan checking in for the first time tonight.
Quite a time for him to check in. 4.5 minutes to go.
An offensive substitution, as you would expect at this point of the game.
Yeah, at this point, everybody up trying to find a last-minute equalizer. As battle on the far side, ball knocked up into the air, headed by the Bulldogs. And then the Tigers, and now the Bulldogs with possession here near midfield, a long ball forward and headed by the Tigers, although right to a Bulldog.
And cleared out by De La Torre.
Yeah. And an interesting play there. And then guys taking shots at both ways. Chef one way in and an elbow the other way.
And we'll just let all that go.
Yeah. You know, been a very physical second half. Although the first half was physical as well. We've seen three cards here in the second half. Four yellow cards on the night. Just under 3.5 minutes to go as that ball bounces off the backside of a Bulldog and to the Tigers, but Tigers give it right back. And more people taking spills at midfield.
Tigers just need to keep their composure during these scrappy last couple minutes.
Yeah, and they're playing it out, so the Bulldogs will have a corner kick.
3 minutes to go.
No signs of a short one here. In fact, the goalkeeper all the way up as well as the line drive towards the center, headed up and over the top. Bulldogs trying to say that was off a Tiger's head, but referee Reed Chrissy points to the goal kick. 2.5 minutes to go. Tigers leading 2-1. 48th minute penalty kick goal by Keenan White. Right now is the difference. And elbow whistled against the Tigers at midfield.
Livermore will come up past midfield to take this free kick himself and might get into the fray in the offensive half as well.
Yeah. It looks like he'll just on the Tiger side of midfield, play it into the box, and it's a high floater in the middle of the box, headed by the Tigers out of the box. Ball put back in, headed away. Bulldogs still with it, looking to get off a shot, and it'll be a corner kick. So under 2 minutes to go.
Livermore is coming up into the Tigers' defensive zone here.
Tigers watching for the short corner, and they'll play it. A floater into the middle of the box, and it's headed down, and it's in. So an 89th minute goal on the corner kick, and we are tied at two.
Looked like it was Ben White, number 7, Ben White with the goal for Gonzaga in the 89th.
So shades of last season. 89th minute goal, and we are tied. And now there's a, looks like a foul, but no foul called. Tigers will try to push it the other way, and there's a foul called against the Bulldogs. And the, a lot of emotion showed there by the Bulldogs' number eight, Michelson. 1 minute to go. Can the Tigers find a 90th minute goal? Ball played into the box. And it's in front! Oh! Although the offside flag was up. So, under 30 seconds to go here in regulation. Headed, and that'll go into the hands of Goldsmith. So,
and just content to send it to overtime.
So, after 90 minutes, we will play on as the Tigers had a 48th minute penalty kick goal by Keenan White to take the 2-0 or 2-1 lead, but Ben White, a header in the 89th minute off a corner kick, tied it at 2, so we will take a short break and be back with overtime as the Pacific Tigers and the Gonzaga Bulldogs tied at 2 on the W.TV. Welcome back to Knowles Field. Paul Meiskens along with Mike Dalgetty, and we head to overtime.
You weren't ready to go home yet, were you?
I had no plans for the rest of the night.
Nowhere else to go.
Still plenty of time before the rain comes tomorrow, so why not play some golden goal overtime? Although the Tigers, heartbreaking way for it to go in overtime. The 89th minute goal by Ben White off the corner kick.
And it was the second assist of the game for Jakob Granlund. So he delivered both of the assists on the two Bulldog goals. And still the only two shots on goal in the game for Gonzaga are the two that resulted in goals.
That, based on quick math, that's shooting 100%.
Shooting 100% when you're on target.
And screw up on the kickoff to get us going here in overtime. So two 10-minute overtimes, although first goal will end it. So see if we can get a dramatic golden goal victory to end the season for the Tigers.
Taking a look at the teams in overtime this year, Pacific lost a 2-1 decision in overtime to Utah Valley early in the year. Lost a double overtime heartbreaker here at Knowles Field to San Diego State, 1-0 back on September 27th. I remember that one. I was sitting right behind the goal when that winner was scored. And then a 0-0 tie after two overtimes at Santa Clara on October 18th. Looking at Gonzaga, they had a 2-overtime tie against Cal Poly up in Spokane in early September. Lost a 2-1 double overtime decision to Hartwick September 11th. And then won a 2-1 overtime decision at Portland on October 11th.
Kappelhoff with it here, cuts it back, a low ball towards the top of the box looking for Blackman, knocked away. So the Tigers, after back-to-back overtime losses, then got an overtime tie, so next step, an overtime win, hopefully to end it, as that shot from long range nowhere near the goal. If only that was true. No, I'd be a little excited to reach the 99th minute. As ball played forward on the far side. And that cross knocked out, so that'll be a corner kick from the same corner that the Bulldogs were able to score off of late. In the second half, the 89th minute goal.
And it will be Granlund once again with the right-footed in-swinger.
Yeah, after the balls he's played, scratched these short corner chances, and that ball loose in front, and it's knocked in. And that'll do it. As the Bulldogs swarm in the near corner, as off the ball there by Granlund, Goldsmith unable to control it, and it was loose right in front and easily knocked in. So a heartbreaking way to end the season for the Tigers. 2 minutes away from the win, and instead the 3-2 loss
in the 93rd minute.
Yeah.
Well, the Tigers will wrap up their 2015 season 1-15-1 overall, 0-6-1 in West Coast Conference play, but with sights set on the future, graduating the first class of seniors, a lot of young players with experience, and we'll be adding more recruits, coaches recruit all year, of course, but in earnest now in preparation for the February signing dates for new Tigers for 2016.
Yeah, kind of a fitting way for the season to end. A lot of close games all season long that unfortunately couldn't go the Tigers' way, and Tigers unable to end the season with a win. So that'll do it here. As I'd like to thank you for joining us all season for producer Corey Crawley, my partner tonight, Mike Dalgetty, SID Corey, or Kurt McCauley, and Ben Lasky, and everybody else. Glad you could join us, as that'll do it once again in overtime. Your final score here tonight, the Gonzaga Bulldogs defeat the Tigers 3-2. This was Pacific Soccer on the W.TV.